Hi, it's Pavel from Global Control 5. iSMA-B-MAC36NL is a Niagara controller with unique functionalities. One of its functionalities are onboard DIP and rotary switches that can be used as a part of an application. Today, we'll learn how to create hand-off auto control of an onboard digital outputs using iSMA-IO module. Let's make a quick overview of an application that we'd like to create. DIP and rotary switches are located on the top board of the controller. They are called S4, S3, S2, and S1. Today, we'll use the S4, which is a group of 8 DIP switches, and S3, that is a group of 6 DIP switches. Please notice that the 6 DIP switch on the S3 is reserved for the factory defaults. In our scenario, we'll use the first DIP switch of S3 to set the hand or auto mode. S4 will be used to set each relay in on or off state by hand. Using onboard switches as a part of an application is super easy. Everything we need is located in the iSMA-IO module. This time, we'll use the S3 and S4 components and digital output component that represents the physical output. Now just a few components from the kit control. We need a multi-vibrator to simulate a logic. Let's call it logic then and set the period to 30 and link it to the digital output on priority 10. The LED on Mac is representing the state of the output immediately. The second thing is the NAT component. Let's call it auto mode on. False state of the first S3 DIP switch will enable hand mode. Now we need end component to put it all together. The very last step is to link it to the digital output 1 component on priority 7 and test if it works. All good then.
All right, I have quickly copied the logic for the rest of the digital outputs to test it on the demo board.
Let's switch off the auto mode and move to the hand mode and switch on the outputs. And switch them off.
This is just one of many examples how you can use the onboard switches as a part of an application. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next iSMA episodes. See ya!